A reading from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, strive eagerly for the greatest spiritual gifts, but I shall show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in human and angelic tongues, but do not have love, I am a resounding gong or a clashing cymbal. And if I have the gift of prophecy and comprehend all mysteries and all knowledge, if I have all faith so as to move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away everything I own, and if I hand my body over so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It is not jealous. It is not pompous. It is not inflated. It is not rude. It does not seek its own interests. It is not quick-tempered. It does not brood over injury. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. If there are prophecies, they will be brought to nothing. If tongues, they will cease. If knowledge, it will be brought to nothing. For we know partially and we prophesy partially. But when the perfect comes, the partial will pass away. When I was a child, I used to talk as a child, think as a child, reason as a child. When I became a man, I put aside childish things. At present, we see indistinctly, as in a mirror, but then face to face. At present, I know partially. Then I shall know fully, as I am fully known. So faith, hope, love remain, these three, but the greatest of these is love. The Word of the Lord.
Our second reading for this Sunday comes from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians. We have been reflecting on love, the love of God, and its many facets or faces. In the first reading from Jeremiah, we see how God has chosen in love this man to be a prophet and sends him to be the messenger of his love to a people who will not love God and his messenger in return. But God is faithful. God will be with his beloved prophet. Now, in the second reading, it is good to go back to the context of the Corinthians. The Corinthians, apparently, from the letter of St. Paul, were a gifted people. They had experienced the manifold gifts of the Spirit. However, you know how tricky things can be. The gifts of the Spirit to a community are manifestations of the love of God, not only for the recipients of the gift, but for the whole community. Now, but weak as we are, we can turn the gifts, not anymore, into gifts of God for others, but as tools for self-interest and self-promotion. Apparently, in the Corinthian community, they accepted the gift of God, but they used the gift of God not for the common good, not so much for the unity of the body. And therefore, they focused on gifts that would, in a way, present the recipient of the gift as someone special. For example, speaking in tongues, speaking in this angelic or mysterious languages. Wow, and when you hear someone engaging in it, you'll say, oh, wow, he must really be connected to the heavens. Or the gift of prophecy, being able to declare, this is what God wants. I speak in the name of God. Thank you. or the gift of being able to do charity. I give a lot of money, I give my goods to everyone, even the supreme gift of martyrdom. Now, all of them exteriorly could be good, but according to St. Paul, if the motivation is not love, then you gain nothing. And the community gains nothing. In fact, when there is no love, these many gifts could be used to divide the community, because the gifts become tools of competition, of pride, of self-interest. And so, in the Christian community, St. Paul is telling us, be open to the love of God. The love of God that comes to us through Jesus and in the power of the Spirit. And let love be the motivation for the use of your gifts and for your ministry. Let me repeat that. Let the love of God be the motivation for the use of our gifts and for our different ministries in the community. Without love, we gain nothing. And so, there are three theological virtues: faith, hope, and love. But according to St. Paul, love is the greatest. Love remains. Why? Because love is supposed to be the direction of our lives. It should be the direction of our service. It is the direction and the fulfillment of all our gifts and ministry. So the love of God should be the fuel that will enable our gifts and different ministries to be used as manifestation of the Spirit and the love of God for the community. In this day and age, social networking has become a very convenient mode of communication among people. With just a click and the power of the internet, you are able to reach your loved ones wherever they are. On the other hand, it is saddening and alarming to know that there are some people who take advantage of the reach and availability of social networking sites, spreading scandals and false information about a certain entity or personality, engaging in fraud and scams, and at times, pretending to be someone else. Recently, I have been getting reports that there are fan pages and personal accounts under my name and are circulating over Facebook. To set the record straight, I have no personal Facebook account. Rather, I have only one Facebook page, and it is being maintained by Jesuit Communications. I seek your help in reporting fraudulent pages and accounts, not only those concerned with myself, but also with other people and entities. Let us keep the social networking world a good communication venue by being truthful.